Editing has always been a major aspect of Fortnite content creation and pro play. Many editing tricks and advanced tactics are being used in Fortnite events by an array of pro players, and well-known content creators are raising those standards incredibly. With brand new metas and editing tricks being pushed out almost daily, well-known YouTubers are breaking the standards and introducing new ways to edit every single week. In this video, we're going to be showing you guys how you can edit faster by looking at some of the best editors in the world, Parallel, Psycho, and Raider. We're going to break down their gameplay and methods to help you guys learn how to edit faster. Who wants to do that? I know I do. Now, most people won't tell you, but editing fast is not something that just comes quickly, all right? Despite what many people are going to tell you, editing has to be built up by gradually beginning at a slower pace. I know we just want to rush and we want to be great. I get it, but you got to start at the beginning. Many of the blazing fast editors you see today only became that way because of hardcore practice. You also need to practice against tougher opponents. So, right before we hop into the video, check out ProGuys.com, the number one resource for getting better at Fortnite. We offer full structure courses and pro coaches to teach you one-on-one. So, I got to ask you this question. What are you waiting for? Head on over to ProGuys and sign up today. What's going on, guys? It's the Motivation Guy. That's right, your friend. Come on, say it. The one and only Keith Allen. How you doing? What's going on? Listen, I want you guys to enjoy life. Continue to make a difference to the people that come your way. Hey, we gotta be leaders, you know, not followers. We gotta be leaders. I don't care if everyone around you has a bad attitude. Why can't you be the person that sticks out? Why can't you be the one that's positive? Why can't you be the one that shows everybody, like, you know what? We're gonna change the world by our positivity, one person at a time. So it's your job to do so, all right? Connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram. I believe in you guys, rooting for you guys. Now it's time to sit back, relax, and you better grab my favorite candy. Come on now, say it with me. It's that Bunch of Crunch. And let's get this going. So, first up, we have Parallel Psycho. This player has recently gotten a lot of attention from the Fortnite community due to this incredible editing ability he has. Psycho is a mainly keyboard and mouse player who actually plays with only one edit bind, which is a pretty cool thing considering how fast this guy edits. Editing fast in Fortnite can be done in two ways. One of these ways is called a double edit bind. All right, so what this is basically setting your edit and confirm button to different keys, meaning that you can go into edit mode and confirm an edit after you've made it with two separate buttons. By doing this, you can simultaneously press the buttons, making it almost instant. That's why the double edit bind is more commonly used by very fast editors. The single edit bind, on the other hand, is a bind that's gonna make one single button your edit mode and confirm edit button. Meaning you gotta press it twice to make a full edit. The first press will enter you into edit mode, while the second is gonna confirm the edit. Single bind editing makes it impossible to instantly select and confirm an edit. That's why, guys, it's just so special that Psycho can edit so much better than the majority of the Fortnite community with just one button. For every single edit Psycho makes, he has to press his edit key twice, meaning that he's gotta press it very, very fast in order to do what he does in these videos. All right, so let's just say that he's pulling off a triple edit. This would be something like, let's say he's putting a floor, pyramid, and wall edit while he's building upwards. This would require 6 clicks in addition to precise movements with his mouse plus perfect timing, all in under 1 second. The majority of players can't even perform this with double edit binds. So imagine how talented this guy is in order to just do this with just one. Psycho is also pretty well known for developing the strategy of taking high ground using edits. This strategy, guys, is now being used by players like FaZe Sway and many pros who compete in these events. All thanks to Psycho making it popular and making it a meta. How this works is Psycho will start by placing something like a ramp and then placing a pyramid, wall, floor, and more pyramids. Then he will edit the pyramid above him twice while jumping in order to gain a layer. He'll combine the basic move with hundreds of other moves he's already mastered before. How he makes it work is by consistently placing items in his path and around himself, which will serve as protection, while he quickly edits them out of his way and it resets them. This tactic is being used greatly by pros and all kinds of players now that Psycho has shown its effectiveness. The secret trick here, guys, comes in how quickly he's able to process the pieces that he places around himself. He knows that he's placing a piece in a certain location before he even places it. This allows him to be ready to pull off the quick edit and run through the direction that he's intending to without making slow edits, which will take away from his momentum. Okay, so one example, guys, is like when he will place items like a floor, pyramid, and wall, and then edit all three in less than a second. All of these structures provide him with extra cover and close angles that his opponents could use in 1v1s or even an arena. By closing these angles, he's lessening the chances of him getting shot and damaged by his opponents. Most importantly, and most notably, you know, Cycle's ability to edit incredibly fast and consistently is what makes him such an incredible editor. All right, so take a look at how quickly he can make multiple edits in a row without the slightest mistake. I wish I was him. And the way he does this in burst really makes his playstyle perfect for competitive play, and it shortens the window opponents have to take shots at Cycle. All right, so are you ready? Let's take a look at some examples of Cycle 1v1ing, and with this, he's gonna be able to show you guys how to practice and improve so that you can improve your edits. And someday, man, even reach his level. Maybe, just maybe. All right, so remember guys, this takes practice, but what practice? What did I say? You can do anything with that. So first we can see that for almost every 1v1 fight Cycle wins, he pulls off 10 to 20 edits minimum. This is something that little to no other players can do. What this tells us is that Cycle is very consistent and that he practices performing multiple edits consecutively a lot. Without practice, there's just no way that Cycle would be able to do this edit this fast. So that's just one thing that we can just learn right now from his gameplay. So the first step is to hop into a creative lobby and practice. Everyone say practice. That's my second favorite word. My first favorite word is darn. Yes, I know, believe it or not, it's weird. But anyways, practice making basic edits on walls, floors, pyramids, and ramps. Learning the muscle memory for the edits is necessary before you can just speed it up. So there's three stages to becoming faster at editing. First, there's muscle memory, then there's speed, and finally, there's consistency, which is basically how many times you could do something in a row without messing up. By practicing an edit individually in consecutive motions, you can work on your muscle memory, right? By practicing increasing the speed at which you perform a single move can improve your speed. And finally, by practicing a chain of moves together, doing them for long periods of time without messing up, all right, well, you just got better at consistency. These practice tips are gonna help you guys edit way better, and they come straight from our analysis of Parallel Cycle himself. All right, ladies and gentlemen, next up, we got Raider464, and this guy's different. The best way to describe Raider is, does that explain anything? Hope it does. Unlike Cycle, Raider actually uses the double edit keybinds. As mentioned before, this basically allows him to edit almost instantly between going into edit mode and confirming his edit. Now, although it seems like Cycle is like super fast, he's like Cycle fast, that's probably why he got his name, just wait until you see some of the stuff Raider can do. Cycle is physically limited due to the fact that you cannot select a single button simultaneously. You have to allow the button to return back up and then press it once again. So with the double edit keybind, Raider can save lengthy amounts of time on every edit he does since they're almost instant. So let's take a look at some of his gameplay to give you guys a good idea of what we mean when we say he can do it instant. Let's take a moment here, all right, and let's pay close attention to how many edits Raider is able to pull off in less than a second. This is just absolutely crazy. Did you just see that? No? All right, maybe we should slow it down. Let's slow it down a bit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and let's watch that again. All right, so clearly, now we can see that he makes two edits on the right side by editing the floor and pyramid. Then he resets both the floor and pyramid back into their original state and once again edits them, but this time on the left side, and then he runs right through it without losing even a little bit of momentum on his run. Bravo, bravo. If we time this, we can see that he's able to pull off six edits in less than a half of a second. Is he real? This is something that is close to, like, impossible to do on a single edit keybind, and it can be considered a limitation. But in the end, it does depend a lot on your playstyle, and not all players will be able to edit like Raider even if they had the chance. Now let's take a look at another example of Raider's speed, all right? And this time, we're gonna show you guys some tips on how you can improve in order to someday be able to edit like this. We all wanna be like you when we grow up. Looking at this clip, we can see that Raider is dishing out edits faster than we can even imagine. In fact, we have to slow this clip down again so you guys can actually understand the edits he's doing here, all right? But let's take a look at the normal speed for a second so that you guys can just see how fast this is in real time. Now that you've seen it, all right, let's slow it down and let's break it down. First, we can see that Raider is placing a floor and then three walls attached to that floor, right? These walls have been pre-edited to have their top off. Directly after placing the three walls, he edits and resets all three while quickly turning back around and editing open the corner of the wall that he's going to be running through. He once again does this all so fast that he doesn't even lose any momentum when doing so. When we say this, we mean that the player is able to edit multiple times so quickly that by the time they reach the arena they're running into, it's already opened up so that they just don't run into the walls or an unedited object. Also, turning too much can cause losses in momentum. In this specific video by Raider right here, we see him performing 100 different edits, all perfectly executed. At even the medium level, we start to see extremely advanced edits that over 99.9% of all Fortnite players cannot do. Hopefully, this gives you guys an idea of how talented and how incredibly fast this guy is. Raider has held on to the title of the fastest editor for months now. So let's get into how you can practice just like him and have a chance at the throne. Who wants to know? All right, so first up, you must use double edit keybinds if you want to get better at editing. All right, period. We suggest putting these two keybinds in a way that you can press both at the same time. You can put these binds on your keyboard, mouse, buttons, or both. If you're on controller, we recommend having edit on left analog stick click and confirm on B. Now that you have double bind, you need to get used to them. You can do so by practicing just going into edit mode, selecting a tile or a few, and then confirming. Doing this for at least 10 to 20 minutes every single day until you get a really good hang of it is going to make all the difference in the world. Once you've gotten the muscle memory down, you need to work on your speed at clicking the two buttons simultaneously, but also the tracing you're going to need to do in between the clicks. Being able to draw out your edits in as little as time as possible is just as important, as there is no point in using double keybinds if you can't actually edit fast enough to take advantage of it. So my friends, I say this with love, practice, practice, practice until you can do single edits almost instantly. So we suggest practicing doing things like wall opening edits hundreds of times per day. Once you can do this fast, chain multiple moves together so that you can start getting fast at editing consistently, not just one at a time. If you can keep this up, you're gonna be editing like a god in no time. Editing is definitely not an easy skill, all right? But it's a very important one to master. After Cycle's contribution of making editing so popular and the usefulness it provides, it's starting to become more and more of a necessity in competitive play. Raider's binds and methods also happen to be the fastest in the game. By combining Cycle's intelligent editing tactics with Raider's incredible mechanics, you're gonna be able to be on your way to becoming an editing pro in no time. So you gotta spend time practicing what we taught you in creative, and you're gonna be guaranteed to improve within days. All right, guys, once again, this is the Motivation Guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. Hope you enjoyed this video. Wanna say we love you guys, rooting for you. Hey, I want you to be the best of the best in every area of your life. Make sure to follow me on my Instagram because I believe in you. All right, so that's it for the comparison. We really hope you had a pleasant time watching today. Remember to use code ProGuys in the item shop as it really does help us out. And let us know what you guys want to see next. We're committed to bringing you guys quality daily Fortnite content. So if you enjoyed this one, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.